Welcome to Studio Sessions, our monthly videos where we share our kits and equipment from our second floor makerspace, the studio. My name is Emily. I am the assistant director. And today I'm going to tell you all about our Cricut Loom. It's one of the kits that you can check out. Now, this kit is a little tricky because it's not one, unless you have some time to come to the library and dedicate a couple hours to it, it's not one you can just do in a half hour. It does take some time, and you can even work with some of our staff members to say, hey, can I get it set up today and come finish it tomorrow? That's a possibility as well. We did not know how to use this piece of equipment, so I took it home and I was like, I'm going to learn this. I'm going to conquer this. Have I conquered it? No, but it is a lot of fun. And I guarantee once you start doing it and you figure out all the ins and outs of getting your yarn on the loom and starting your weaving, you're going to fall in love with it too. I love it so much that I want to invest in my own loom now. So that's the great thing about the studio. You can come and try kits before you invest in the equipment yourself to see if it's a hobby you're going to like. So I'm just going to show you the basics. I am not an expert, even though I've taken it home. I will leave some links in the description down below so that it shows you how to warp, which is adding your yarn onto the loom itself. There's two different yarns, really, your warp yarn and then your weft yarn, and that's the yarn that you weave in and out, but we'll go over that a little more in a second. And then I will also leave a video on how to tie off. So when you're done weaving, what do you actually do? There's some great videos on YouTube, and I'll share a few of those with you because they'll explain it a lot better than I can. But this is called a rigid heddle loom, and that just means that this right here with the reeds, that is referred to as the heddle. So there's different kinds of looms. This is the rigid heddle loom. It's sometimes we have a kid's loom where it doesn't have the heddle and you are just weaving directly through. It just kind of has a frame. So this is a little different setup than that. So this one, you do have the warped yarn and then your weft yarn. So on this you have, so this is called your warp. When you are tying on, you can do single colors, you can do multiple colors. There are some people that can just weave beautiful things. They know how to put the colors together and in what order. You do not have to put as much yarn as there are spots in the heddle. Now on your heddle, you have, these can come in different sizes. So this, I believe, is a 5 DPI. They come wider. So if you would like to use a thicker yarn, you can get a different heddle that would have a thicker yarn, more space between each reed. And then the eyes are a little bigger. And these little eyes are the circles in the middle. Because when you are warping, you're going through the slots and you go through each slot and then you have to go back through and pull yarn through the eye. And so what that allows for is that when you lift up, right now our loom is in the neutral position. That means all of our yarn is sitting together. So I'm going to lift it up and it separates. So the yarn that's through the eye right now in my up position goes high, and the yarn that is through the in between the reeds, that's the low. So those are separated. So that is creating a shed. And what the shed means, it's just giving a space for my shuttle here, which I have added yarn to. I did different colors. So I warped with one color and then I'm weaving with another. So this is your weft yarn. It gives a space to put your shuttle through to do your weaving. And when you do that, you're going to pinch on one side here. You don't want to do it too tight. Oh, I'm backwards. Hold on. I'm going to go back. I need to be in the low position. I'm unweaving. You don't want to do that. So I'm going to go low. And when I go low, the yarn between the reeds comes up and the yarn in the eyes goes down. So it just switches. So you're just changing your shed each time that you move. So now I'm going to put the shuttle through. I wasn't paying attention. I'm sorry. Again, I'm an amateur. I'm just having fun with this. You're going to pinch here. Leave a little extra because you don't want it too tight. If you do it tight, then it starts to pull your edges in. So you're just going to pinch so it stays. You're going to leave your yarn at just a little bit of an angle to give it enough yarn when you push down, because then you're going to lift your heddle and you are going to pull it towards you. And then you're going to go into the up position. And so you just switch back and forth, sending your shuttle through the shed, pinching the edge, making your little angle here, pulling it down, go to the low position. So it's very soothing. It's relaxing. It's a lot of fun. Once you get past how do I actually warp, which again is the trickiest, and I'll have some videos for you in the description, then this part is just really fun. You can be watching TV, listen to an audiobook, which is what I like to do, and you just go back and forth until you're done. Now you will notice that the more I weave, the closer I'm going to get to my heddle. So then you also have these gears on the side, and these are called either ratchet dogs or pawls, which I like ratchet dog better, I think. And that just holds your gear tight, but you can loosen these up, and then you can, depending on which way you're going here, I needed to go the other way. There we go. I can pull it so it's winding down here for me to give myself more room between my weaving and my heddle. I'm going to put those back, and then I'm going to tighten it up just a little. You want to work on another tricky thing that just takes patience and time is making sure that your warped yarn is at a pretty even tension. That's something I've struggled with a little bit, but I'm getting better the more I do it. So you just want it to be about the same tightness all the way across, because that will also affect your weave. Now in our kit, we have our resource guide, which lists some different materials that we have here in the library that you can check out. So if you do fall in love with this and want to learn some patterns, there's some great books in the collection. We also have some additional QR codes if you'd like to watch some videos. This is the guide that kind of tells you, it gives you a head start on how to warp. The videos were a little easier for me, but if you're better at reading something, we do have the kit in here. We have two books you can look at, Inventing Weaving on a Little Loom and Weaving Made Easy. So a couple books to give you some inspiration on some projects that you can do. We also have an extra shuttle. So if you did want to weave your weft yarn, again, the ones that's going horizontal and your warp is vertical, you could have two shuttles loaded up with different colored yarn, and then you can switch between. And you'll see a couple pegs in here. These hold, you only need these when you are warping. And warping just again means adding your yarn to the loom itself. These go into the loom to hold it tight on the table because you don't want this sliding around. And then you also have a third clamp with a peg, and this is your warping peg. So you will stretch out and wrap around this as you're warping, and then you end up tying it all into the loom. And finally, you're going to see a threading needle. This is what you put through the eye of the heddle to pull through your yarn to get it ready to weave. Other things that I found are handy, they talk about cardboard warping sticks. What you really want to do, I just used an old paper sack from the grocery store. Or you could use scrapbook paper or wrapping paper, a thicker wrapping paper. I use it on both sides to have my yarn and my weaving wrap around it. It just helps keep that tension level and keeps you from getting tangled up. So as you're rolling on, as you're using your gear here to tighten or loosen and to roll, you just add that to it and it rolls in between, so it just levels things out a little bit. Again, it's a lot of fun. I hope you come in and check it out. I know it's intimidating looking, but once you learn how to do it, it's a lot of fun, very relaxing, highly recommend it. If you have any questions, make sure to come see us at the studio and stay crafty.